Hi everyone, welcome to the visual guide for Catissus Hyperborea. This is the fourth new leveling dungeon made available through the MSQ in Final Fantasy XIV and Walker. This instance is laden with mechanics, and wiping in here might have you seeing double. But before you dash your skull in, I'm here to give you a new Lisa on life. My name is Miztek, and I'll be your dungeon guide. In this first section, be on the lookout for the massive AoE attacks that will spawn more adds. Use your cooldowns appropriately and burn everything down. The first boss is Lisa. Skull Dasher will target the tank for high damage, cooldown and heal. Throughout the fight, the boss will move to the center and cast Frostbite and Seek before disappearing. Players will then have to use the footprints in the snow to determine where the boss is. Move to the snow mound where the footprints end to avoid getting blasted by the attack as the boss returns. Icicle will form icicles around the platform. The boss will then cast Frigid Stomp, dealing group-wide damage and causing any icicles on the platform to shoot out in a specific pattern. Players will need to move away from these areas to avoid getting hit. Heavy Smash will target a player for stack up. The group will need to stand together to share the incoming damage. All of these mechanics will repeat until the boss is down. The next section has some fairly big pulls if you choose to run wall to wall. Burn everything down as quickly as possible and don't forget your cooldowns. The second boss is Leyden Lord. Scratch will target the tank for high damage. Cooldown and heal as necessary. When the boss casts Inhale, players will have to pay attention to which head begins to glow. The boss will then jump into the center, face a random direction, and cast Pyrrhic Breath. Players will need to move away from the glowing head to avoid the incoming conal attack. During the next inhale, the boss will inhale twice, and two of his heads will begin to glow in a specific order. For the next Pyrrhic Breath, players will have to dodge the first head before moving to dodge the second head. Pyrrhic spheres can form around the platform. These orbs will each explode in a cross pattern, and players will need to quickly determine where the safe spots have formed to avoid getting hit. Intimidation will deal group-wide damage. Healers be ready. Pyrrhic Blast will target a player for stack up, and the group will have to stand on them to share the incoming damage. All of these mechanics will repeat until the boss is down. In the last section of trash, players will jump from platform to platform, fighting mobs all the way up. Watch your feet and dodge those AoEs. The final boss is Hermes. Trismegistos will deal group-wide damage. Healers be ready. Hermetica will create large green tiles on the outer edges of the platform that will soon blast out directly in front of them. Players will need to move into the safe zones to avoid getting hit. True Tornado will hit the tank for high damage. Cooldown and heal as necessary. Meteor will target the platform with multiple proximity-based damage markers. Dodge in between two markers at the edge or in the direct center to avoid excess damage. Meteors will then appear on the platform, three cracked and one whole. While this is happening, the boss is casting double Hermetica, forming tiles that cover the entire platform with no available safe zone. Players will need to use the meteors to avoid each blast by hiding behind them. Cracked meteors will disintegrate after a hit, so use the whole meteor to easily dodge both sets of blasts. Next, the boss will cast double True Arrow. The first part of this attack will target all players with unavoidable line attacks. Spread these apart to avoid overlapping. After the first hit, a second set of lines will appear in the same areas, but these can and should be avoided. True Bravery is an interruptible cast that will buff the boss. Interrupt this to avoid excess damage. Eventually, the boss will cast a quadruple Hermetica, and four sets of tiles will appear in a random order around the platform. These will explode in the order that they spawn in, and players will have to pay close attention to the angle of each blast to avoid them appropriately. Double True Arrow 2 will target each player with circle attacks. Spread these to avoid overlapping damage. Immediately after, another set of circle AoEs will form on the ground that players should avoid. The next double will affect the tank buster, and the tank will need to move out of the ground circle attack after the initial hit. These mechanics will repeat until the boss is down. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. Up next, we're heading down into the Aetioscope. As always, thanks for watching. Till next time.